Hi guys, so welcome back to an episode of Jives Fishing. So today we are at Labrador Jetty.
Yep,
so anyway, right now it's about 9 to 10 a.m. Yeah, it's going on high tide very soon. So the plan for today is that we brought some live prawn from CC at Yishun just now. But the plan for today is actually to jig for bait fish or most likely tamban that can be found around the jetty lah, according to many of the regulars, and we've seen them before lah, so hopefully they are around, especially now during high tide. Yeah, so we plan to fish maybe until at night. Okay, we'll see how things go. Okay, see the weather, see the bite rate, everything. So we just got set up a while ago. Yeah, so anyway, we'll keep fishing and we'll update you guys again later. Okay, so anyway, we brought some frozen tamban. I think I forgot to mention. Yeah, but problem with frozen tamban is that it will draw off the hook very easily. Yeah, so what we do is that we take a bait needle. So you can see it's a bait needle. And we put it through a hook. So, yeah, something like that. Yeah, so what we do is that we thread this thing through the tamban. It's like threading a needle like that. That's why we call it thread it. So we're going through the mouth, and we just like push it through. Oops. Okay, I'm not doing a very good job, but yeah. Okay. Yeah, I think it's stuck somewhere behind. Ouch. Okay, yeah. Basically, this is what the end product should look like. The hook coming out of the mouth, then your snoot coming out of this tail. Yeah, so you can just stick out the needle, then this thing you will clip to a swivel onto your main rig line. Yeah, so that's basically what we are doing. Usually I know people tie bit thread, yeah, but we don't have it lah, so too bad lah, we're just doing this. Yeah, hopefully it casts better and it stays on longer lah.
Yeah, we're still trying out.
Yeah, we're still trying
we
out.
We don't really stuff. Do this.
And you got suggestions again, please do let us know. Cause
especially the surf casters, I think y'all will be more experienced in this.
Yep. Okay, so anyway. There's a lot of seaweed coming in from outside. Yeah, so it's most of our lines have gotten seaweed stuck on it. Yeah, so you can see like the rod shaking, but it's not fish, it's seaweed. Yeah, like for example this one. Yeah, so anyway, it's been like that for a long, long time. So that's quite unfortunate, but don't really have a choice, so we'll just wait and see. Hopefully it passes. I think it's because the wind is blowing inwards now. Yeah, so hopefully when the wind change direction or the current change direction, then it should be fine. Yep. So anyway, update you guys again later. Huh? Think on the end line. You drop.
Go.
Anggao, really anggao.
This is the spotted one, very nice. Black throat bombers, maculated.
Alright guys, so that was a coral trout, yeah, or anggao, or blue spotted grouper, Dactropomus maculatus. Yeah, so anggao honestly is one of the fish that most Chinese people love to eat lah. Mainly because it's the skin red color, then for Chinese it's like very lucky lah, red lah, ang is lucky lah. So yeah, that's why the price is very very high lah for coral trout, especially in the market. Yeah, so anyway, we strung it up on a hand line so it won't die. Yeah, so I think we'll probably bring it home to clear it or something lah. Yeah, that one is a good 35 to 40 centimeters. Yeah, keep size for coral trout actually should be about 30. Yeah, cause coral trout, okay, most groupers, they are protogynous hermaphrodites. Yeah, so that means right, they start off as a female, then they have a sex change somewhere in their lives, and the bigger ones are usually male. Yeah, so if you want the population to sustain, you should let go of the small ones. Yeah, so usually about 30 cm ish, they will hit their adult size, so they will have a sex change to male. Yeah, so anyway, we will keep fishing and update you guys again later. Time now is actually in the afternoon. Yeah, time now is in the afternoon, about 12 to 1. Yeah, so it's a lowering tide. So I'm trying to jig for a big fish, see the stability. Yeah, so basically what we are doing is just like dropping it down at various like places around the jetty. So like all the way down, then we jig, then we crank a little bit, then we jig. So we haven't been getting a single big fish at all. Yeah, so I think we are doing something wrong. For those people, if you all got any experience or suggestions, right, please do let us know in the comments below, because I'm quite sure, I don't know, maybe there's another method to do this. Maybe I'm doing something wrong. Yeah, so I'm not too sure about it. I'm just doing what works for like other places or what works for me last time. But I know that for every spot, there is like something different you will need to try, you will need to experiment. Yeah, so if you guys have any suggestions or what, can just let us know in the comments below. Yeah, we'll read the comments. Yeah, thanks a lot, because we are not getting any big fish. So anyway,
actually no one else getting lah, so yeah, I think it's just the day.
Maybe it's the tide, yeah, it could be the tide and all that, but yeah, anyway, yeah lor.
So yeah, just comment below if you have any suggestions.
Yep, so we'll keep fishing, update you guys again later. Yes.
Oh,
that's right.
Okay.
Finally we got. It's interesting. Put on the float.
Yeah. So this is a trash left behind by someone. Yeah, and look at the mess. These are left behind by anglers.
Alright guys, so last night update, there's been zero action, yeah, unfortunately. So now it's about 7, yeah, going to dark already. We're gonna change our bait to Kelong Sotong soon, yeah, and hopefully things will be better at night. Yep, so anyway, keep fishing, update you guys again later.
Alright guys, so that's the end of our short session. The night was honestly pretty bad. Yeah, we tried our best. We had kelong sotong, we tried to eggy to catch sotong, but there were no bites, so the crab just kept stealing the sotong. And yeah, so unfortunately there's nothing else to show for it lah. Yeah, time now is about 10-11 at night. Yeah, so we are both quite tired. We've been here the whole day. Yeah, so anyway, if you guys have any suggestions for us, yeah, do drop it in the comments below, or any advice, any tips for fishing at Labrador Jetty. Because I understand some of y'all might be a lot more experienced than us. Yeah, this is like our second trip there or something. Yeah, in a long time. Yep, so anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode, and hope to see you guys in the next episode. Bye.